Hey YouTube. Go live. Might have to zoom in a bit on this. Can you see that pretty decently? Okay, yeah, it's already good. How big does it get? Cool. Okay, hey, how's it going, everybody? Let me put the monitor. There we go. I can hear myself now. Ooh, hold on. It is that. There we go. Much better. Cool. So, we're going to work on the lyrics for that thing that I made. Let me... Honestly, I just want to do lyrics. Like, I don't even want to try to shoehorn them into the rhythm of the thing. I just want to write the lyrics, and then we can make them fit later. I think that's what we're going to shoot for today. So, here you see my songwriting worksheet. I put this together a while ago, a few months. Back when I was doing lyrics every day, and this is kind of the thing I came up with. It's some like keywords and general thematic stuff to keep in mind. This whole thing right here, all of this. Is it's like an epiphany I had one time having I was, to be completely honest, I was in an altered state of mind, and this kind of just came out of me. It's like what a metaphor is, and like how, you know, a song is like an essay, like right there, argument, thesis, kind of ish, you know. It's like this and this. And this, thus, this, like the whole three pieces of evidence and then thesis statement. So I broke it down to where I have this little section. I don't know if I've ever showed you this, so I'm just going to show you. This is like a breakdown, a simplification of this section up here. The way I think about it is like 1 equals either 1 or 1 prime. So like something to do with 1. Next you have 1 to 2. So 1, 1 prime or 2 equals 1, 1 prime, 2 or 2 prime. And so on. All the way down to 1, 2, 4 equals 1 to 4 prime. I didn't do 1 equals 1 to 2. 1 to 3 equals 1 to 4, because I wanted to make it a little bit more like, well, let's make sure that 1 prime has something to do with 1, this kind of thing. And it's like, this is this, and the way I'm thinking about it is we have like different sections. It's like 1 to 1, V1 equals 1, the chorus is 1 to 1 prime, so verse is chorus, verse 2 is chorus 2. The bridge is a whole section of that, so like 1 to 3 equals 1 to 3 prime, so you can say a little bit more in the bridge. And then the resounding statement that 1 to 4 is 1 to 4 prime. That's kind of just a guideline I came up with. I think it's really useful. If you want to write songs this way, this is a really useful way for that I've found to do it. So, all that being said, we're going to try to get started on it. You may have noticed the title up here, Wood Arose. I came up with that on the this morning. I was like, we were talking about Wood Arose by any other name, not smell as sweet. That famous line from Shakespeare. So I wanted to maybe do a little something with it. and then maybe share my songwriting process with you. So yeah, we have the name, we have the music. By and large, we have the music. And it does basically go by the structure of first chorus, bridge, or solo, and then outro. Do we want words for the chorus? I think we do. All right, well, maybe just some words, or even like a choir of just sounds, voices. So the way I start this is kind of go broad and then slowly narrow my focus. So start with what arose, what is the song about? So what arose, let's just add would a rose by any other name not smell as sweet? Sweel. Would a rose by any other name not smell as sweet? Would a rose. But the thing about this, I think, is that it implies that something fundamental about this. about this thing is something. The qualities of this thing are fundamental, I think, is what that line implies. Like, Juliet, by any name, would be as sweet as she is. And while that's mostly true, it's like whatever you call this thing, it's gonna be what it is. But the thing that came into my mind, because I thought about the name, like the title, Wood of Rose, it's like Wood of Rose, you know, this is an example, probably won't be a lyric, but like, would a rose growing out of a pile of shit be perceived as beautiful as a, you know, any other rose? It's still a rose, but do people love it? Is it something that people are going to come find, you know? Or, like, if a rose, would a rose that, you know, wasn't watered enough, that kind of stuff. So like, sure, a rose is beautiful and a rose is something that's truly a sight to behold, just because it is what it is doesn't mean that it's beautiful. Like, it can still have some some shit, some baggage that you know, might be a bit off-putting. So that's kind of where my head's at with this. Would a rose by any other name not smell as sweet? What if it's growing out of poo? What if it's water malnourished? What if it's in a bed of roses? What if it's too close to the ground? All kinds of crazy circumstances. What if an animal pees on the rose? So like, yeah, sure, a rose by any other name will smell just as sweet, but it's not the name. I don't know, I'm still playing with this idea in my head. A rose by any other name not smell as sweet. Yes, and the point of that is, again, it's like, fundamentally, a rose is beautiful and smells wonderful. But there are certain factors that... Basically, what I'm getting at is that nurture versus nature. Like, a rose is a rose. It's born a rose. But, you have to cultivate the rose. You have to grow it and give it sunlight. And like, a rose doesn't just become a rose because it's a rose. A rose, grows into a rose if it gets all the things it needs. I think that's what I'm going for. Nurture nature. I don't normally include all of this stuff, like keywords and whatnot. Mostly I just think about what the song's about, but I think for the sake of this video, I'm going to maybe include a little bit more. Probably won't, because I already have... maybe at some point if I notice I'm using a particular rhyme scheme. We'll see. We'll see what I come up with. Let's see. Sorry. Keywords. Bed. Thorn. Petals. Puns. Let's remember puns. That's one thing that Andrew Huang talks about is...
Bless you.
Thank you. Hey. If you're writing a song, puns help because double entendre. You know. What else do we have? Mulch? Is mulch a lyrical word? Stalk. Bush. Let's just put it down. Bush. Bed, thorn, petal, stalk, bush, sweet, smell, light, water, leaves, red, green, Juliet, Romeo, what's his name? What's the guy's name from Romeo and Juliet? He's like kind of a douche. Benvolio? Let me see. Benvolio. Yeah. What does he do again? Montague's nephew, so he was a peacemaker in the play, so he prevent violence between the... Okay. Okay. Maybe if it fits. Benvolio. Poison? Some words. Let's see if I come up with anything else. We already have the tempo and time signature. So, we'll use a guitar. We want trochees, IMs, who knows. Mm-mm. Look at that. Spelt all incorrectly and stuff. There we go. We'll come up with that as we go. The thing about music is you get away with a lot. A lot of inconsistency. Whatever we come up with, we'll come up with. Right now we're just going in broad strokes. We'll ignore the rhyme scheme for now. So, we're getting into the first section of actually creating content. Coming up with themes for the song. So verse 1. What happens in verse 1? So what does that evoke? We're going. So that's the chords. So what does that evoke? This evokes... This is why. I don't know. I think this is a good limitation, though, honestly. Because honestly, we'll see. We'll see what happens. Do-do. Do-do. Mm-hmm. minor song. So the harmonic movement is going. This is honestly, so this is the first time I'm sitting down and like processing the harmonic meaning and trying to assign lyrics to it. Just coming up with concepts. Trying to understand what's happening in each section and trying to like extrapolate meaning. What time is it? Oh, it's 3:06. Okay, so in a little bit I'll have to just hop off, but I think my goal for this session is to come up with what each section, at least what a first few, up to maybe the second chorus is about. So I don't want to goof around too much. I think of that as pretty spiky, like thorns, you know? So thorns. Thing one. What a rose. Roses get de-thorned. Did it. This happens for a good minute. Not a minute, but like. So that can be where we introduce the thorns. So those are the thorns, kind of abrasive, kind of pokey. Roses get dethorned. So do we want to go one prime? Do we want to go... What is our thesis statement? Thesis statement is it's not actually how this works. So yeah, let's go. Roses get dethorned is like this. This. That is like this. Doing like a Phrygian thing. Lydian. Phrygian. Makes Lydian? No. What else has a Lydian still? Think something like that. I forget. It's probably not really any kind of tonality, but Phrygian Lydian kind of stuff. Borrowed chords from a bunch of different modes and whatnot. Roses get dethorned. So let's maybe, so same thing, roses. Trying to think, like maybe rose petals. But no, it's just get dethorned. Would a rose be a rose without its thorns? Roses. Could we do with this? Roses get dethorned. Would a rose be a rose without its thorns? Roses. The other part of this is that I try my best to avoid judgment in these moments, just like put down what I want to put down, and then I'm able to distill, like, because, like, this isn't a lyric. You know, what a rose without thorns is not a lyric. Would a rose be a rose without thorns? It's a little, like, on the nose, you know? So, fortunately, what this is great for is being able to get the idea of the song and then distill from the sour mash, you know, interesting. So what we can do, anyway, let me finish that thought. From the sour mash, you can distill the whiskey, right? We're good. So from these rough ideas, you can distill a more pure, raw, not raw, but a pure, more potent version of these rough ideas. Like you're distracted. So maybe something else. Roses get dethorned. People get, women get, roses get dethorned. I have to think about the allusion here. Allusion, the A-L-L-A-U-S-I-O-N. We're referring to Juliet, right? Honestly, I probably need to study up more on the metaphor itself, what happens, and why it's so appropriate, like why it's such a big deal in the play. Then I can draw some parallels, but I think I might be able to draw my own parallels here. So roses get dethorned. So what happened to Juliet? She's all pretty and perfect. And, you know,
Where's Maggie? How you doing, baby?
Romeo. Capulet? Forget who's the Montague and Capulets, but Romeo Capulet, Juliet Montague. I don't know. I think that's right. She's that. It doesn't matter what her name is. Romeo loves her. However, just like a rose is beautiful and sweet, it's still gonna prick you. So maybe the roses get dethorned. But the whole thing is like the context does matter. What ends up mattering is the name. If it wasn't for the name, then they'd both have lived by the end of the play. Right? Like, so that's the whole thing. It's like, it doesn't matter what her name is, but it does. What a rose. It does matter what the name is. What roses get dethorned? Would a rose be a rose without its thorns? From there we can go. I like the rose petal thing, like the rose petal, like sprinkling them everywhere and being all romantic stuff. Like, the name does matter. Why does the name matter? Names matter. Anybody watching? Anybody hanging out? Now we get a reaction. Nice. Oh. Here's Peep. Really low. Scoot it down a little bit. There we go. Even farther, maybe? There we go. Okay. This paper says thorns. Time is... It's probably about time to hop off. Yeah, I got 9 minutes. Okay. Let's get this verse. Let's get the second verse and chorus down. So... We want to draw parallels because the music is very directly paralleling. I want to expand upon it, though. So maybe, like... Roses, if you call it... Why do names matter? Why do names matter? There are things called... You don't go to... Everyone knows when you know the name, when the name becomes more than the thing, when a name becomes more, when the name becomes something more than just a name. Names become just a descriptor. Description. See, now I'm thinking that I don't like the first verse. Names become more than just a description. Where's the strike through button? There isn't one. Format. Text. Ah. Control Alt Shift 5. Okay. Yeah. Oh, wait. Yeah. Okay. Dethorned. We're going to try those again. But we are going to come up with something. So, names become more than just a description. A name doesn't just, it doesn't just belong to the person. Names become more than just a description. It doesn't just belong to the person. This is getting into like transness. I think, I think that's the direction this is going. Transness, dead names. Transness, dead names. Identity. Ownership. Of the self. Boundaries. So because of that name, because of the name Capulet or Montague or whatever, either one, both of them really, Juliet didn't belong to herself. She belonged to her family. It was the name that kind of made it, that mattered. Like, what's in a name? kind of everything, you know? If you change, if you keep it, it means that you're accepting who you are, where you come from. There's a lot in a name. Like, there's a lot that comes with a name. I'm thinking about all the things that roses are, you know, it's a powerful word. The word itself is honestly even more powerful these days than the flower is. Okay, I like this. I'll probably rework verse 1 and chorus 1. Names become more than just a description. It doesn't just belong to the person. I'll probably make verse 2, verse 1, and then work from there. Because 1... Yeah. Right, because 1 introduces a thing, chorus... A. Whatever. Cool. This is fun. I like where this is going. We'll work on it more tomorrow. God, I'm so glad that I get to take some time and think on these rather than just throw them up in a day, because this is a lot more relaxed and chill. Okay. All right, Facebook. I'll see you next time. I love you, as always, and I will, we'll finish these lyrics tomorrow. Well, not finish them, but we'll continue these lyrics tomorrow. I want these to be, like, good. I want to fine-tune them. I want to come back to them, revisit, edit, craft them, rather than just, you know, vomit a bit on another page. So, I'll see you later. Have a good day.
Happening in about 2 minutes.
Yep, I'm getting off. Bye, YouTube. I love you. See you next time.